A cyclone is a violent storm that originates over oceans and tropical areas and moves over to the coastal areas, bringing about a large scale of devastation due to violent winds, cumbersome rainfall, and storm surge. It is an irregular wind movement involving closed circulation of air around a low pressure center. This closed air circulation, whirling motion, is a result of rapid upward movement of hot air which is subjected to the Coriolis force. The low pressure at the center is responsible for the wind speeds. Cyclonic movements are usually anti-clockwise in the northern hemisphere and clockwise in the southern hemisphere. This phenomena occurs due to Coriolis force. As freaky as it may sound, cyclones are often characterized by existence of anticyclone between two separate cyclones. Under favorable conditions, multiple thunderstorms originate over the oceans. These thunderstorms merge and create an intense low-pressure system which causes a cyclone. There must be a large surface area. The temperature must be higher than 27 degrees. There must be persistent Coriolis forces acting upon the cyclonic vortex. There must be some slight variations in the vertical wind speed. There must be an upper divergence above the sea level system. A cyclone always begins with a thunderstorm. During this, air rises as it is warm and light. At certain height, due to lapse rate and adiabatic lapse rate, the temperature of air falls and moisture in the air undergoes condensation. Now, condensation releases latent heat, making the air warmer, hence becoming much lighter and rising even higher. The space is filled by fresh moisture-laden air. Condensation occurs in this air and the cycle is repeated as long as the moisture is supplied. Due to excess moisture over oceans, the thunderstorm intensifies and sucks in air at a much faster rate. The air from the surroundings rushes in and undergoes deflection due to Coriolis force, creating a cyclonic vortex, a spiraling air column. As the storm system rotates faster and faster, an eye forms in the center. It is serene and clear in the eye with meager air pressure. Higher pressure from air above flows down into the eye. The rising air warms the core of the disturbance by releasing both latent heat and direct heat transfer from the surface of the sea, and the atmospheric pressure in the center of the disturbance becomes lower. As a result, the pressure decreases and causes the surface winds to increase, which in turn increases the vapor and heat transfer and contributes further to the rising of the air. The core becomes warm, and the increased surface winds thus fortify or reinforce each other in a positive feedback mechanism. It is also said that the impact of tropical cyclone also depends upon the number of individuals living in low-lying coastal areas within the storm's direct path, the built environment like the design of the building, and also on the sufficient time for warning and evacuation. Cyclones are divided into categories depending on the strength of the winds produced. There are many different classification scales, but one you may be familiar with is the Saffir-Simpson Hurricane Scale. This scale is used to describe storms in Hollywood movies, example, Twister and The Day After Tomorrow. When the maximum speed of a cyclone is 63 km per hour, it is known as a tropical depression. When the maximum sustained speed of the cyclone is more than 63 km per hour, then it is known as a tropical storm. Loss of human life and property. Increase in waterborne diseases. Disrupt health systems, facilities, and services. It also left communities without access to healthcare once they are needed the most. Psychological and emotional exhaustion. Damages basic infrastructure, including food and water supplies and safe shelter. That's pretty much it for today's video. Do like, comment, and share. While you're at it, don't forget to hit the subscribe button.